I'm going to turn this huge pile of slash behind me into some beautiful biochar. About 7 years ago, this property was select logged for cedar. This is the tops, the limbs, the junk they didn't want. You can see there's some fine stuff in there. There's some dirt, there's some grass, there's some larger pieces. I'm gonna pick through with my excavator, get the larger pieces out of the way because they're gonna be too big to biochar, get the dirt and the junk out of there and pick through and grab the medium sized stuff and get that into a pile so it can start drying out. We can get it in the kiln later. I may be a third or a halfway through my pile back here, our biochar pile here. Trying to keep it about 6 inches and smaller, so a lot of branches and stuff in here. Then I've got the large stuff, the butts and stuff that there's no way I can biochar those, they're too thick. And then the third pile here, mostly dirt and decomposed bark and junk that I'm just kind of sorting and filtering through. I found that with the excavator, you can kind of grab it and sift it a little bit and get a lot of that dirt out of there. You really don't want a lot of dirt in there because it'll just smother your fire. And one thing I thought of in the next couple of weeks, if it gets pretty dry, I can come back with the excavator and turn it, I guess, get the bottom on top and get it dried out, because you really want that fuel moisture down under about 20% for the biochar kiln. Well, holy moly, did I make a mess. Biochar fuel kind of running in a windrow down this way. And then on the other side there, you can see there's another windrow over there where the excavator was. But boy, oh boy, now I gotta do something with all this stuff. All right, next stop, biochar. Today's the day. I've got a burn ban coming on in about a week with the county, and so I gotta get this stuff burned. It's been sitting here for several weeks, been drying out. We're gonna use this steel burn bin here, and I've just grabbed some stuff off the pile with the excavator that I'm gonna start my pile with. Now, the thing that you wanna know before you even start burning or thinking about burning is what your fuel moisture is. Because if your stuff is all wet, it's not gonna char very well, it's gonna make a bunch of smoke, it's just gonna make a big old mess. So now I wanna check the moisture level, and this is just a cheap moisture meter I bought. And I'll just grab a stick here, and you take these two little prongs, shove it in there, and that one's at 11%, 12%, hopefully you can see that on the camera. I've got a bigger one here. This is a bigger branch, it's maybe 3 inches in diameter, and it broke when I pulled it in with the excavator. So I wanna, let's do this. Let's try two things. Let's test the outside. And that comes in about 12 or 13. And now I wanna check the inside, like kind of right in the middle of the branch. And we're at 14 right there. And you can tell, I mean, this thing doesn't weigh hardly anything. It's very light, you know, I can tell it's very dry. All right, let's test my fire building ability here. I'm hoping this grass and sticks are dry enough that it just goes, but I might need to change my strategy here. I don't know, that looks pretty good. There we go, bing bang boom, fire. So I'm gonna let that work its way down into a little bed of coals. I'll keep adding some stuff by hand, but you want to get a real good base going before you start dumping stuff with the excavator. The whole principle here is to burn in an environment with a lack of oxygen, and we're using the steel tub because the sides are going to prohibit any oxygen from getting in the sides, and everything has to come down the top. And I want to show you when we're starting here. You can see the smoke, it's just kind of hanging in the side of the barrel, and then it rolls up the top and rolls into the fire. And that's what we want to see, is this rolling action. And it means all the air is coming right over the top and right down into the fire. And that's going to starve the bottom for oxygen. And everything down at the bottom is just going to be hot coals, and it's just going to pyrolyze itself with the heat. And only the very top layer is going to burn. But you get this little puff of smoke come off when you typically add fresh fuel, and then as soon as that starts combusting real good,
it'll all go away. You can see the flames coming up through it right now. So let me stand back and I'll show you. A little puff. A lot of that's probably water vapor. And then as soon as that gets nice and hot, it'll, there you go. See, it's pretty much all getting consumed now in the fire, and now we got no smoke. So very, very little emissions with this process if you have dry fuel. And man, is it working great. You got a little bit of flame on top, but if you look down there, it's hotter than blazes. And when the wind blows, you can see the fire start, but then when it goes out, it's just pyrolyzing itself. It's getting nice and hot, very little smoke again, which is great. I'm just kind of working my way, nibbling away at the pile here. I'm taking out some of the larger stuff, making a separate pile. I've got another kiln coming. Right now I'm only putting about 4-inch. Now that one sticking out the top is probably about 5, an old spruce limb. But pretty much everything going in there now is about 4-inch and smaller. And it's working so good. It's working perfect. It's just great. Been going for about 6 hours now. I've got the whole bin full. There's a few larger pieces on top that are still working down, but I think we've got a real nice full bin of char here. Well, I stole every one of my wife's garden hoses. I've got them strung all the way out. There's a pond back there in the grass, but hopefully what we have here is just a huge mountain of red hot coals pretty much all the way through. And the outside here has a little bit of ash on it. It's burned and the carbon is being burned now, but all that whole mound in there should be super hot. It should be pyrolyzing or have pyrolyzed all those big pieces. And now I'm just gonna cool it off, stop the process, and then we'll have our biochar. It's gonna be hard to cool that whole pile off, but this, well, let's see how this goes. Yeah, that's not gonna work. I'll get it best I can here on the surface, and then I'll go over with my excavator and dip out of the pond with the bucket. I got everything pretty well knocked down. Look at the bin though. Woo! Bin's hot. I don't know how hot you gotta be to do that, but it's hot. You gotta make sure this is completely out, or if I leave it tonight, it might reignite and just burn up all our biochar. So I gotta make sure it's really, really, really out. Let's see if I can get it back there. I'm spilling it all. I think I'm gonna bring the bin to the pond rather than the pond to the bin. There's water pouring out the bottom of the tub. I've put maybe 6 or 8 scoops on there, maybe more. Oh yeah, it's just, it's floating. It's a floating. See if I can find a piece I can break with one hand. There you go. See, just char all the way through. And I don't know if you sprinkle pond water all over it, does that inoculate it? There's a question for you. Before we go, I wanted to show you here. I used up, I don't know, maybe a third of what I have. I still have all that pile there and that little pile over there, the finer stuff that we can char. So I figure I got probably 2 more burns here.
Now it's time to get this stuff bagged up so we can do another load of char.
I've got some bigger pieces that didn't quite char all the way through. I'm just gonna throw those up into the excavator bucket, and then I'm gonna fill up buckets, 5-gallon buckets with the char, nice fully charred wood. And we'll put it in these super sacks. First 10 buckets done. And I wanted to show you what I was finding is stuff about this size and smaller, charred all the way through, about 3 inches, especially as I get down deeper. When I was on top, like the last big stuff I fed in, it didn't really char all the way through. And you can't tell on the video probably, but if you hit it and it doesn't break, it's still got wood in the middle. There's some wood right there. So I'm hoping as I get down deeper and deeper into this pile, even the bigger size material, those up to 4-inch
maybe 5 inch, got charred all the way through.
Pro tip, if you guys are doing it in a big kiln like this, rather than getting in and trying to shovel out of it, just stand along the side and shovel into the buckets in the bin. It's way easier, you're not lifting it as far.
The other thing I've noticed is a lot of the bigger pieces are right in the middle. And along the outside, there's not nearly as many uncharred pieces. So I don't know if it's getting smothered or there's just not as much heat building up in the center as there is on the outside. But it seems like I'm picking a lot more bones out of the middle than I am out of the side.
Empty bin. I got 1¾ bags. Those super sacks full. I ended up with 79¾ buckets. It turned out really, really nice. Here's an interesting thing. This was the bones or the oversized from the top half of the pile. And here's from the bottom half of the pile. So very, very little in the bottom half. Most of it was in the top half. And I also think there's probably maybe some fuel moisture issues going on here. The larger the material, the longer it takes to dry out. And we're in June, and it's been really nice for the last 3 or 4 weeks. But that big stuff, and if it's on the bottom of the pile, it may not have been very dry. And then I throw it in there and it's just wet and kind of smolders. So that is the results from our biochar slash burning experiment. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks everybody for watching. And we'll see you on the next video.